Yeah. one, whether it is or not, that's my memory, that's stupid. So a lot of them, you know, have that kind of initial spark and it's like, wow, you transmit information over the ether, isn't that really cool? Mark got his bachelor's degree in electrical engineering at Mississippi State after growing up in the Delta in a near a little town called Holloway. And he went over to Georgia Tech and good fortune to come east and got a master's degree in electrical engineering after, as he told us, sleeping on an air mattress in his office. I mean, I don't guess any of you have ever done that, right? Trying to get things done. He lost MFJ in one room of what was then kind of an old run-down Starkville hotel. $9.95 circuit board you built, and he told some of the students this afternoon about starting from there. He grew up as a grocer, and many of the Chinese in the Mississippi Delta had done, and he'd done everything from sweep the floor to cut meat. And so he kind of had a background, wanted to continue in that business realm. Today, MFJ is buying another company, and they're not getting bought. So he's doing some things right. And 90% thereabout or more is American made or assembled. Wow, and he's committed to doing that. And I think when he bought Pushcraft, he kept some of his work there at least immediately. And, you know, that's not quite as disruptive in the answer as it would have been. But he's built it very much, I think, as Frank Sinatra would have done it. He's done it his way. He has automated a lot of the assembly and soldering process, and that's increased his quality control. And he's done it in a way without a lot of flashy dash. If you go on Industrial Road, you won't see a big sign that says MFJ. I don't even think you'll see a sign at all. I went out there one day and kind of stumbled in, met his chief, because Richard Stubbs, because his wife worked at the research center out there. I got a full tour of it. The whole process went up into the tour of Martin's Museum of Radio that he had in Dawson. Very low-key, you know, kind of thing. Go to any manufacturing plant in Atlanta. Go out here to room these to the NCR plant to be the CP1 or anything. Very low-key operation. But I want to mention something before I introduce him. His daughter's in the office. I think Deanna's here. At least raise your hand. Listen, she's getting married, so, you know, as one dad to another, buy more MFJ.
Funny saying welcome to Atlanta, both from Starkville, but it's all yours.
Well, thank you very much, Frank.